dummy cut.
Oh, oh, don't pull a hammy, mate.
Who are we?
Three Māori boys from Whakatāne.
That's who we are.
We make and market Wai Mānuka, which is a premium non-alcoholic beverage infused with
Mānuka honey, sparkling water and lemon.
It tastes like liquid sunshine in a glass.
We want Wai Mānuka to be global, to be a multi-million dollar company.
I think it's extraordinary that New Zealand businesses are brave enough to export. To win an export, you have to have something that's different, that's special.
It's giving people hope.
That customers value.
It's like gold, bro.
And will pay for. And to do that with 5 million people as a base is really tough.
Oh, yeah, we could fail. There's no guarantees, but that's business.
I te kaihanga ka inoi ki a koe, ki a manaki te mai mātou I tēnei ata, ki a manaki te mai mātou whānau, kainga kainga maha, manaki te ira, e mauiwi ana, e rawakore ana, e pani ana, uhia mai o tō mai rangi a ta whai ki runga I a mātou kātō I tēnei rā, ko rōrea ki te ingoa tapu, āmini.
Āmini.
Ko Wayne tōku ingoa. My name's Wayne. I'm in charge of marketing and distribution.
Kia ora, Lance Folder, I hope. And I'm in charge of production.
Tēnā koe, ko Joe Haruara tōku ingoa. My name is Joe Haruara and I look after filling any gaps. There's a massive opportunity before us, but the biggest thing getting in the way right now is our finances, or lack thereof. We've got bills that are overdue. We've exhausted all our personal funds. So, kia ora. Anyone got any pūtea for us? Hook us up.
Hey.
None of us have any beverage making experience, so it's really important to have people around us kind of guiding us.
Kia ora. My name is Rhea Cowell, and I'm a customer manager at New Zealand Trade and Enterprise.
Kia ora koutou. My name is Rangi Māori Irirunui, and I'm an investment manager at New Zealand Trade Enterprise.
One of the big things with us is around trust, and we absolutely trust Rangi and Rhea to have them on the journey with us.
Now you're sitting down, you're going to say thanks.
Oh, thanks.
Nailed it.
No.
So tell me about these three fellas.
Here we go.
Do you want to start with the good stuff or the bad stuff? It was an interesting first meeting. I think they were like, who's this fellow on the other end of the screen? I said, hold on, I'll tell you who I am right now.
Yeah, I was just like, wow, who's this flash Māori fellow?
The first time I ever came aware of Wai Mānuka was actually a colleague at work that had told me that there was these guys that are coming up with this Mānuka product that seemed amazing. Yeah, I think the first sort of thing that surprised me was it started as an idea at New Year's, and then how quickly they'd been able to commercialise and actually make a bottle of Wai Mānuka.
Cheers, guys!
Woo! So that New Year's Eve, we were sitting around the barbecue and the boys were having a few drinks, and I was on the kombuchas that night. As the night sort of progressed, I was like, man, somebody's got to make a better tasting non-alcoholic beverage than this. And then we said something like, what if we mix Mānuka honey with water?
I got the old soda stream out.
I was the head scientist. We added our ingredients, but unfortunately, we did have this accident occur.
You know, soda stream, you do the water first and then put the stuff in, but what we did is I actually put a bit of honey in the water and I stuck it in the soda stream and the whole thing like exploded everywhere. Break the whole soda stream, but that's how we roll, eh? We break a few things to get to where we want to be.
After the soda stream incident, we actually spent quite a few months doing research and development into it because it's not that easy. And you know, if it was, everybody would be doing it. This is our side hustle. We're all in full-time jobs.
You know, we're doing a lot of juggling, but we manage it. Some days are a bit harder than others, but we're just doing the best we can.
We've gone into this with the idea that we're creating a product that's fit for purpose for the high-end market in Dubai.
How did you pick Dubai in the first place?
Because it was one of the toughest markets to crack into. We thought that we'd go hard straight away. We actually got advised to start a little bit closer to home, but we thought, nah, we'll just go to the
Have you checked out our market guides on MyNZT? It gives you kind of a fair idea about what it's looking like. One of the things we also have is a market comparison tool that you can use to help you select which market might be right for you and your product.
Yep.
For me, what I'm gonna do is have a look at connecting with you, Wayne, with your marketing hat on for the digital marketing, and also doing a little bit of work around figuring out that market validation for you. So Lance, you're gonna be looking at the pricing strategy. We've got Mr. Business Development, Joe, and he's gonna look at Sky City and Government House.
My real dream is to be a full-time entrepreneur, and then also to use it as an opportunity to hopefully inspire other young people on their business journeys as well to follow through with their dreams and aspirations. So I live in Wellington. My day job, I work for New Zealand Rugby. Born and bred in Whakatāne, obviously. So I did a bit of formal study, ending with an MBA through Massey University, and I guess it kind of lit the fire in terms of that entrepreneurship. When we first started out, we wanted to get into business to stay more connected as mates.
And what we've found is that that's actually evolved, and so it's no longer just about us, it's about the community and the support that we've received. You know, it's about Whakatāne now, and what can we do for the town? Whakatāne has had a really rough couple of years in the wake of the Whakaari incidents, where there was a massive loss of life, and the town is still hurting now. So when that happened, there was a deep sense of sadness that still exists today.
I've known and I've looked after a couple of people that have been affected by it seriously. And so for us to come out and do this, try and bring a bit of a ray of sunshine into that darkness that was held over the town for 2 years, it's good for us, you know, and it makes me feel proud.
Hopefully we're helping people to heal in a way that's really positive, because people see a sense of themselves and us. You would not expect three Māori boys from Whakatāne to come up with a premium non-alcoholic drink.
Going to market, going globally.
You really can't connect those dots. That's like a Taika Waititi moment.
Big time.
Taika, sequel to Boy, three Māori boys. Oh, the America's Cup changed everything. We were just lucky enough to partner with Te Pau, so New Zealand House, at the Viaduct during the 36th America's Cup.
A mentor of ours just said, hey, this is an opportunity that you could get your beverage into. Apply it next minute.
But they didn't really know how to make the most of it from a digital marketing point of view. I took the opportunity to help them with the digital marketing bit first, just to get their thinking aligned with how to best optimise the America's Cup for them.
Man, it was just like, it was unbelievable. Like, at that stage, we hadn't even made the drink.
Kind of where it all started for us, eh?
Yeah.
The profile. Yeah. The awareness.
Still growing.
Can we go over to Emirates over there and see if they can ship it over?
We're sticking on one of their wakas in
there. There's our cargo.
No, off the back of America's Cup, we grew pretty quickly in terms of our partnerships across the country. So we're in some pretty esteemed establishments and outlets like Sky City, Karaka Cafe, St. Alice Restaurant on the Viaduct, some high-end places. Eh? Yeah. We had a great idea, we had an amazing plan, and then we got punched in the face. Started off with exploding bottles.
So we had exploding bottles on our production line.
We lost $19,000.
Then we lost 4,000 litres of our premium baby product, you know. It's heartbreaking to see that. It really hit me hard. It was the most stressful moment of my life. It impacted me deeply. Production is my line of operation in the company. We had to start again from scratch. My neck was on the line there, actually. But lucky I had the two boys, they supported me through that. So I'm store manager for Kopi Super Liquor. So the skills that I've learned here in terms of retail, selling, customer service is gonna help me excel in our Wai Mānuka company. So I grew up in Whakatāne, born and raised here, school here. And me and Joe born in the same week, same hospital, same room. Parents worked at the same place. We went to the same primary and intermediate school together, and that's where Wayne came on the scene.
We are brothers. Even though we're brothers from different mothers and fathers, you know, it's like, we're still brothers, eh? We feel like we're blood.
At the end of the day, our sort of friendship will supersede whatever Wai Mānuka will be.
So, what's keeping you up at night at the moment?
Oh, money. Yeah, it's finances.
Yeah.
If we can get bottling nailed down to it's all in-house without having to send separate components away to be finished, we're saving money.
Yeah, and it's just easier. Just remind you what it looks like now, so the products come together.
Yep, so the inputs arrive, we bottle the beverage, but then it gets sent on to be relabeled again and repackaged again. And the costs that are involved are ridiculous, so we hemorrhage money. We want to purchase a neck label applicator. Currently, our production line doesn't have that facility. If we can secure these loans to actually buy that piece of equipment, it's just going to be way more cost-effective.
Yeah. So working with Rangi on that?
Yeah, Rangi's been great, so he's been looking at some options in the business sector, the iwi, as well as the banking sector.
Got money to ramp up?
Bro, we printed off the P&L sheet. We're in the red big time, eh? So we're a bit nervous.
Raising capital for an early stage business is probably one of the hardest things to do. There's a big difference between having a vision and getting other people to buy into your vision when they're buying into nothing on paper.
It'll be a minimum. We need 150,000. But we know, looking at the figures right now, that's likely to be no unless we can convince them of the potential.
Rather than going for equity funding at this point, we're going for bank funding. Equity is probably not a best option because people don't really want to invest at that size. I'd rather see the boys export, increase their sales so that the valuation of the company goes up so that they don't have to cut the pie up too early.
I actually had this convo with the head of banking up in Auckland and he's going to sort you out a meeting down here in Whakatāne.
Sharp, brother, awesome.
We're your number ones.
Shorts and jandals.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah. If it's a good proposition, it's a lot easier to get people to buy into your vision.
And they've got a good proposition?
Yeah, sure. No, of course they've got a...
From the moment I met them, I knew that they had a great idea and they had the right personalities to make it a reality. Then the product itself is, I think it's really well timed based on the current market preferences. Everyone wants to know a story or the story behind what they're eating and what they're drinking and why Mānuka has that story.
Community is everything for me and for my whānau and all of us. We feel it.
Oh, Tamariki, haere mai. Awesome work, nearly there.
I was born in Wellington, but I moved to Whakatāne when I was a very young boy, and I grew up most of my life in Whakatāne.
Tēnō pai rau atu. That's outstanding.
I think it was a beautiful upbringing. The place itself really helped me grow. The friends and the whānau get really tight. I could go from each friend's house and feel like I was their child as well. That's what it felt like. We all looked after each other.
Help each other out, remember to talk. Walk each other up.
I'm a senior teacher. I love my job. It's my passion. It's my first passion. It's to be a part of education, yeah.
Hey, stand up straight. I roto, breathe it in. Yo ho nui tō haki waho, let it go out.
You know, if we push this further, we really want to bring our community together using, you know, employing our local people because that's what we're all about.
Haurotanga means health, well-being, wellness, all of the things that we need to feel healthy and fit, basically, from the inside out.
The well-being, spiritually, physically, looking after our loved ones as well, big factor for us.
Like, if you're not healthy, then you can't look after the ones that you love and care for most. So it's one of the big reasons why we created Wai Mānuka.
For us, that whanaunatanga part is all around sort of the connections and relationships and the long term. Like, that will always come before doing any sort of business. You know, we're effectively merging a te ao Māori lens over a business. It's more than just the bottom line. We're also into the importance of social benefits, cultural benefits, and the environmental benefit.
Kai te ākitanga, manaakitanga, care of place and people is such an important part of the way they operate.
It's so important to our local story to ensure that the inputs were local. That coastal story stretches from Tauranga, which is where the water comes from.
The honey can come around from far as the Cape, you know, around the East Coast.
And then down to even Hawke's Bay, which is where the lemon juice comes from. Mm. Three Māori boys just bring it all together.
People love New Zealand products around the world, and the Māori story on top of that is a really interesting proposition for markets to understand.
The Māori business story is doing so well overseas, mainly because there's so much brand value attached to it at the moment. You know, the long-term horizons we have, the resonance we have with our land and our inputs.
We live down the bottom of the world, we're far away from all the different markets. For us to be able to trade well internationally, we have to trade in a really premium and value-add space, so we have to have these wonderful stories and histories to back it up.
Like, I feel like we're at a point now where we know we've got the product, so the innovation's on point, but the marketing in terms of the brand story and everything else, we know that it's not quite where it should be.
Yeah, and I think in going international now, like, this was clearly designed with a dream to go internationally, but now that that's coming more of a reality, that refinement of what the brand looks like is really, really important.
We've invested too much to not listen to the people around us. Te brothers.
Te brother.
Tamariki
makaurau. Tamariki
makaurau. So we're meeting with Jesper and Morag. Holy hecka. It's epic we've got all these experts helping us on our journey, eh? What are some of the things we want to get out of these Auckland meetings?
Well, do we have the funds to do the export?
And I think Morag would definitely help us through those problems.
Espa's going to want us to get some brand personas done for the market that we want to enter.
Yeah. I'm good at storytelling. I am good at looking at brands and seeing their unique story and finding ways to communicate it. So they have created an amazing product, of course, and they are so passionate about it. And the way they tell their story, it's so exciting. It's hard not to be engaged by it. And I think you guys have managed to capture the taste of New Zealand in a bottle like no one's done.
I'm getting a bit emotional now.
Really, the only thing you can guarantee any of your consumers will ever see is your bottle, right? Your bottle is the hook. I think they really truly believe in their story. And what they've managed to do, which is the hard part, is they've taken all of that and created a packaging design that brings it to life. So you have to communicate everything you got through that, and they've really nailed that.
My name is Are Katera Maihi, also known as Cuts. I am a tamoko artist, or Māori tattooist, and I also do Māori traditional carving. The design references a lot of stuff that comes from te tai ao, or the environment, the natural environment. We have referencing to pūhoro, which is movement in water, movement on land, just movement in general. Also, inside the pūhoro patterning, we have unaunahi, the ocean, and also to the tidal pull of the moon. I'm definitely proud to be a part of this design and this label, you know, this inu, you know. That's a drink that is from the earth, about the earth, and, you know, these guys' souls are from that too.
So your bottle, check. Yep. Your packaging's amazing. Yep. What's the shipper it comes in? Does that reflect
standard.
Your... Does that reflect your story?
No, it doesn't. Standard,
does it reflect you being a premium brand?
Probably not. No.
So it's all the touch points. Yep. So when it arrives at your five-star restaurant, it looks the piece from day one,
from
right?
Day one.
And we haven't talked much about this, but it's a little bit of social change as well. What you're saying with your product is you can have a special occasion moment with products that elevates that occasion without consuming alcohol, right?
Yeah.
And I think that's pretty powerful as well. I think the world's moving in that direction.
Yeah.
Like if we go outside now, we see billboards for 0% beer all over town. So people are moving in that direction.
Bro, St. Alice on the viaduct.
Look at us. Here we go.
Look, we put these specific mocktails on the main menu a couple of weeks ago. Just in the past couple of weeks alone, it's been, you know, like the response has been incredible, eh? We're stoked. Yeah. Just to have like a more sophisticated offering. Yeah, just ultimately do something a wee bit different to everyone else as well.
What's the main demographic that are attracted to these fabulous mocktails, gentlemen?
Health conscious urbanites in their 30s probably, you know, somebody that wants something a little bit different, healthy. You know, wants to enjoy themselves, wants something really tasty, but doesn't want the alcohol or the calories.
It's like gold, bro.
Look at that ray of sunshine.
Hey?
Me.
My brother.
What do you reckon?
When I look at that, I see a little bit of Whakatāne sitting on that table in the middle of the viaduct.
It's a different feeling, eh, when you see, like, people drinking it and you don't know those people and they're enjoying it and they're smiling. Like, you feel like going over and say, just watch it.
Challenges will be once they've found the market they want to target, and that's a fairly mechanical process, a logical step of assessment and analysis. Then it's actually making it happen in market. Making it happen in market is all about partnering with the right people.
Sorry, we don't have any Wai Mānuka, we're sold out.
That's what you told me last time.
The Māori positioned us like it's all about a celebration, it's about the occasion, it's not an everyday drink.
It's not like just a fizzy drink. If you put it in a glass, you smell it first. So it's got a nose, it's just like drinking a white wine. And then the taste is Mānuka. And so you get this complexity, which is a combination of aroma and flavour. Those things give it a premium. So how are you going in terms of sort of restaurants, going more with food and being occasion-based more than thirst-quenching?
Yeah, well, coming off the back of America's Cup, we managed to secure something like 30 local partnerships.
Oh, cool. They have to get very specific about whereabouts they want to play the game. Who distributes to high-end restaurants and bars? How do you get inside those large, high-end occasions where something like, you know, Prosecco or champagne or the non-alcoholic version, Wai Mānuka, sits?
So we're in the Sofitel, which is one of our premium partnerships, and we're feeling like really elated right now because we're just sort of reflecting on the last sort of year.
We never thought we'd be sitting here, let alone drinking our own premium product in here, that's for sure.
Cheers, boys. This is the lot.
Do we look ripped?
We're surprised at how quickly it's expanded too. Like, we started off in the wellness studio and then we went into the restaurant and bar, and then now we're in every room in the Sofitel, which is, man.
So the boys decided really early on that Dubai was a market that they were interested in. Dubai has some really interesting tariff structures. Primarily, it's the potential that they might have a sugar tax. There's also a carbonated drinks tax that might be incurred. So if that was to happen, it would actually double potentially the retail cost of the boys' product, which might make it a really difficult market for them.
So what you're saying is Asia might be a better home for Wai Mānuka than Dubai?
Yeah.
These countries closer to home are in a time zone that's more similar to ours. Just the ease of doing business in different time zones, especially if none of you are working full-time in the business, is an extra thing to do in the middle of the night sometimes, which is not what you need.
It's a great call, Rhea.
If Hong Kong decides they want Wai Mānuka, then it's really important that they are in the market. You have to be in market regularly. When I was in Pret A Manger, my life for 18 months was a week in New York, a week in Hong Kong, a week in Tokyo, a week in London, repeat.
And so if this goes really well and you identify a market, you validate it and it looks really good, would any of you be interested in actually going and working in one of those markets?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. 100%.
Yeah. So you move whānau?
That would be tough.
Being a father, it's one of the most important things in my life. I really have a role, a responsibility to make sure that I teach my children the right way.
Yeah, it worries me a bit because, you know, the family whānau is me. Those kids and my wife are me. But I know that the support is there and they give me blessing to go to whatever I need to do for success for the whānau, because when I win. They know that. And then if I win, boys win, we all win.
And they've got the peace of mind that we're all together anyway, so.
Yeah, we're brothers at the end of the day. Because the love's always there, eh? The aroha's always there. You know, and then that's what we feel.
Myself and Lance, we were actually born in the same ward, and our dads worked together at the local mill and that, so pretty much known Lance my whole life, and then met Wayne at high school, and then really reconnected over the last few years. So the relationship with I guess it's the same with what we expect in our business relationships. So everything is about relationship. Yeah, it'll be there after Wai Mānuka. So we're on our way to the bank to hopefully get a business loan of $150,000. And it may not seem like a lot in the grand scheme of things, but it is for a business in our position. And I'm a wee bit nervous as well. Put it this way, if I was sitting on the other side of the desk at this meeting and I was basing my decision on the figures I had before me, so our P&L sheet, I would be saying, yeah, nah, buddy. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to go in there, convince them of our story, and hopefully that's enough for them to invest in the potential. If we don't get it, then the journey just becomes a lot harder and it'll take a lot longer. So we'll see how we go. Hopefully I don't let the brothers down. But I don't want to go now. Yeah. Now I've made myself nervous talking about it. Wish me luck. Oh. I'm ready to go, pumped. Not too nervous, excited. We'll see what happens.
Bankers tend to go through a box-ticking exercise at times when they're evaluating you. They look at your collateral, they look at your income, they look at your security, all those sort of things. If the bank funding's not successful, back to the drawing board. Kia ora, Rangi speaking.
Hey, kia ora, brother, how are you?
Kia ora, bro, I'm good. How are you going?
Hey, bro, just ringing to let you know, too, I got out of the meeting with three of the managers. It was pretty daunting.
Yeah, right. And how'd you go?
We chatted for about sort of 45 minutes, 50 minutes, and then kind of at the end, they were like, thanks for coming in, blah, blah, blah. We're not going to give you the 150K. And then I was just like, oh.
Ooh.
And they were like, we're going to give you 200K. They're going to give us 200. The $200,000 is massive for us. It's a huge one. What it's going to enable us to do is to buy a piece of machinery to allow us to produce more units at a cheaper rate.
Check this out, guys.
Check it out, man. Look.
Oh my God.
There it is. Oh, check it out, bro. Going global.
And it's also going to help us to prepare for the export markets. It's a game changer, mate. That's what that 200K is.
Building export businesses can be very lonely. It can be really challenging. It is risky. And so holding on to the dream through it all is so important, because nobody else will have your dream. You have to own it.
Holy heck out, brothers. 200K.
Yeah, bro.
So we're
going
to do it again.
We're going to be like, oh, bro, everyone's like this.
The future, who knows what the future holds? But one thing's for sure, we're going to give it everything we have. Because for us,
it's not if, it's when.
I'm always a man that runs at 100% confidence, so I've got no doubt that they'll be successful. Oh, yeah, they've asked me about being the CFO. I'm just waiting until they can afford me.
I think they're going to be successful because they're putting a lot of their own efforts and energy into it. It'd be such a pleasure to see them stand on the world stage. Bring it on.
Cheer, brother.
Cheer, brother.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, brothers, we're off we run. Let's go.
Bro, did you have the eggs benedict?
I did, but without the hollandaise sauce, so just eggs on toast.
Oh, yeah. I don't eat, mate. I'm fasting.
Oh, right, bro, your body's a temple,
mate.
Bro, this guy is a pure athlete.
And cut!